We're here today to discuss Sono-Photo Dynamic Therapy, a treatment that we've been doing at Hope for Cancer Treatment Center since 2001 and has a lot of validation in the literature, in vitro studies, animal studies, and also patient outcome studies. And Dr. Quintana, you've been with Hope for Cancer since 2009, about?
Yeah. And, yes, almost 9 years.
Almost 9 years. And also, been working complementary medicines for over 25 years. So,
yes,
wow,
right.
We have a lot of information to share today. And Dr. Salinas, thank you for being here as well.
You're welcome.
The first thing we have to understand is that sonophotodynamic therapy is non-toxic. It's safe and can be used for an extended period of time. Let's discuss how sonophotodynamic therapy works.
So first of all, we need to understand that Sono stands for sound and photo for light. So basically what we do is we give our patients a sensitizer. That sensitizer latches into cancer cells. Basically, we see a ratio of latching to cancer cells 70-1 cancer cells versus healthy cells.
And before you go on, a sensitizer is a non-toxic product that is not synthetic. It's a natural product, right? So there can't not be any adverse effects to this sensitizer that we call SP Activate.
Yes. Yeah. And then after the SP Activate is latching to the cancer cells, we start stimulating the different areas that we want to stimulate, you know, if there's a tumor or lymph node affected or metastatic lesions, we stimulate those with a specific wavelength of light or ultrasound. Change between them depending on, you know, if the tumor is deep in the tissue, we prefer to use ultrasound because it has better penetration. If it's superficial tumor, we can use only light or both of them.
And when Dr. Salinas is talking about stimulating, what he's referring to is once the cancer cell has absorbed the sensitizer, that product in itself is dormant. It has no biological, biochemical, or physical activity till it's woken up by sound or light, and then we generate reactive oxygen species.
Reactive oxygen species, exactly. Mm-hmm.
So this reactive oxygen species is toxic to the cancer cell.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Basically, those are like high energy molecules that will move thanks to the stimulation of the ultrasound wave or the light inside of the cancer cells, and those movements will oxidize different organs in the inside of the cell, you know, mitochondria, nuclei, cell membrane. So basically we oxidize the cancer cell from within.
And that causes cell death, which can be called apoptosis or necrosis. And so, or the medical word is oncolysis, lysing that cancer cell. The good part of all this is that we also see two additional benefits, right, Dr. Quintana?
Yes. The one of the effects of the sonophoto is the blocking the formation of new blood vessels. So it's inhibiting the nutrients to go to the cancer cells. It's one of the ways it also works.
And that's a hallmark of cancer. It's called angiogenesis, so we're blocking that way that cancer cells are able to absorb nutrients and also eliminate waste. And then on the part of the immune system, it's has an indirect effect on immune stimulation as well.
Actually, it has an activation of immune system, and basically we help the body to, you know, start an inflammatory process, good inflammatory process, control inflammatory process on the areas that we're stimulating.
And upregulating the innate and the adaptive immune system. We see things like dendritic cells maturing better. The benefits of the sonophotodynamic therapy also on the immune system and the blood supply has to do with the vascular endothelial growth factor and diminishing that chaotic circulation that cancer cells tend to have. Whereas normal cells are not affected because that blood supply in normal cells is more structured, it's healthier, and it's more organized.
Right? Yes,
it's not as easily disrupted as blood supply in cancer cell. So we talked about the three main effects of sonophotodynamic therapy, which is to generate reactive oxygen species, that causes apoptosis or necrosis. Secondly, is the effect on the immune system. And thirdly, is the effect on disrupting the blood's flow.
Blood supply.
We know that's one of the hallmarks in cancer, of all cancer types, is the ability of cancer cells to form new blood supply. So that being said, Dr. Quintana, which cancers can we treat, or maybe which cancers can we not treat with sonophotodynamic therapy?
Basically, all cancers can be treated except the ones they don't have any solid mass of solid tumor, like, for example, leukemia, and brain cancer. Basically, will be probably the two that cannot be treated with this.
Right. And even though brain tumors are solid tumors, the thing is that the sound and the light cannot penetrate the skull, right, to get into there. So with the sound, we get to deeper locating tumors. And with the photodynamic therapy, the light therapy, it's more superficial tumors. How have you seen throughout the years, Dr. Salinas, that patients tolerate the sonophotodynamic therapy?
Oh, it has an amazing toleration. I mean, all our patients tolerate it really well. I haven't seen any secondary effects due to sonophotodynamic therapy. I think it's one of the safest therapies that we have available.
We have some patients who have been doing sonophotodynamic therapy at home for maintenance or prevention now for 2, 3, 4, 5 years and tolerate it very well. And an acute situation at the clinic, Dr. Quintana, because some of our patients are very ill, right? They have anemia, their lack of energy, maybe they have poor appetite and they're not feeling too good. We still can and do provide the sonophotodynamic therapy.
Yes, actually there is no limitation for the patients. We can do the therapy completely. It doesn't matter what the shape of the patient is.
Mm-hmm. And I know, Dr. Salinas, that you have been part of the home program team and also the admissions team at Hope for Cancer Treatment Centers. When the patient is discharged from the clinic, oftentimes they continue on the sonophotodynamic therapy at home. And what does that process look like?
Well, we give them a device which will deliver the ultrasound waves. And basically, they take with them the SP Activate, which is the sensitizer. So they take that sensitizer weekly for the rest of the year. And we give them specific instructions on what areas, for how many minutes, and the different wavelengths and frequency that the device has to be set up with.
So we know that some locations where patients have to do the sono or photodynamic therapy may not be very easily accessible, or the patient can't reach, right? So we have their spouse or their adult children help them with it. That's how easy this is to do.
Exactly.
Throughout the years, we've had patients tell us, you know, doctor, when I do the sono therapy, it feels good, right? Because this is energy medicine. And energy medicine, we're energy beings. And you've heard that throughout the years, right? Yeah. Things like what? What do they say?
Well, they improve overall the symptoms. No, they feel more energetic. They have a better appetite. They keep more active. They sleep even better. So there are different symptoms, the way that the patient feels much better than
these,
the beginning.
These important quality of life parameters,
quality of life,
right,
exactly.
that improve significantly. And as part of our non-toxic cancer therapies, it combines very synergistically, for example, with hyperbaric,
it can
with
be
ozone,
combined with other therapies and other supplements, mm-hmm. yes.
And specifically oxygenation. This is why we recommend patients at home, when they're doing sonophototherapy, that they exercise or rebound or oxygenate, because we talked about one of the mechanisms of action being generating reactive oxygen species. And so any cell that is malignant and you're pushing oxygen at the same time that you're doing sonophoto, you're going to have maximum benefits.
Yes.
So
yes.
It's a safe therapy. It's an enjoyable therapy. I've had patients even tell me, you know, I can't miss a day because it just feels good, right? So,
yeah.
So thank you, Dr. Quintana, for
You're welcome.
This wonderful conversation, and Dr. Salinas.
You're welcome, Dr.